Fast Stack of Comics here, representing Dark Avenger Inc. Plus. I am Mark, aka the Bagging and Boarding Bad Boy.
And I'm Chloe, the Geek Chic Comic Mystique.
What time is it?
Adventure time!
Oh. How's it start out? It's adventure time, come on, grab a friend.
We're going to a very distant land. Jake the dog and Finn the human. Something, 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 it's adventure time!
It is Adventure Time here with the cover B to issue 18. And this starts off leaving right where it left off last time. You've got Ice King Wizard and Jake, the crab monster, like, took them out. Finn just rises up with just, like, a bold warrior and just, like, he's gonna take care of them. So he comes to the rescue and he takes down the crab monster and he revives his friends. And then after they defeat the crab monster, they get a treasure. And this treasure, it's never what they're wanting. I think they're wanting riches and gold, rich stuff, as they say in Goonies. Oh, but they never get anything like that. This goes to, like, Lichland, like, another dimension. And then when they get into this dimension, Jake, like, gets... No, Ben gets Jake's stretch powers, which is kind of cool and kind of different. And then they end up hooking up with BMO and Bubblegum Princess, and they eat dog treat cake. That sounds like fun. I mean, my God. Who doesn't want to read about that? I'm not being sarcastic. It's pretty cool. I don't want dog
dog so treat cake. Yeah, like dog treat cake.
But it's still pretty funny. I love stuff like that in comic books. But really cool. And then you see Ice King Wizard is like going around looking for Finn and Jake. Can't find them. He stumbles across an old girlfriend who's like held captive. That was really cool. Didn't think anybody could love Ice King Wizard.
Apparently someone did.
Yeah, apparently. She's not bad looking.
Huh?
Not as pretty as Chloe, but she's not bad looking. And then we'll get the conclusion of this arc next time. Really good issue. Then you get a second story that's dealing with Y-Wolves, and it's very academically rhombus. So rhombus. It's just a real short story. Nothing really major happens, but it's just a good little short story. And one thing I really like about the Adventure Time series is you get little captions from the author. I don't know if it's Pendleton Ward or what, but they go right along with the story. They're just really small right there. You probably can't even see it on the camera. Just really small there at the bottom. And they just kind of enhance the story. They're just kind of funny little comments on what's going on in the story. I always enjoy those. They enhance the story for me. And just to be honest with you, since I've been like really getting into the Adventure Time comics, this is the best issue I've read so far. I loved this. They're always good, but this one was definitely my favorite. Just great fun, great action. The jokes just really hit this issue. Very funny stuff. I loved it. What did you think?
I absolutely loved it. I adored it. As always, Adventure Time is just awesome and adorable. But this issue in particular, seeing... I guess whoever it was that fell in love with Ice King, like, seeing them reconnect was just like, oh. And then, like, seeing Jake with Finn, or Finn with Jake's powers was, or Stretchy, was really cool, too. And then it seems like Jake was in his, yeah, they were each in their own separate worlds, like, kind of off in a daydream, sort of, and that was really cool.
Yeah. So would you rate this issue?
Definitely a 5 out of 5 at Stacular.
Definitely. I'll give it the Fat Stacular stamp. 5 out of 5. This is Adventure Time, issue number 18. And we appreciate you guys rocking out with us to some Adventure Time. And until next time, until the next Adventure Time, everybody stay action-packed.
May your stack be fat.
Duff.